Hello, fishers. My name is Matt McLaughlin. I'm with the Division of Marine Fisheries in Gloucester. And today I will be your guide to the setup and operation of the eTrips mobile application. If you do not have the application downloaded, links are included in the associated text regarding where to find it in the Google Play Store or in the Mac App Store. I'm going to be doing this demo on an iPad, but Android tablet operation should be nearly identical. Today's tutorial will specifically address the current need for electronic reporting of horseshoe crab harvesting, so I'm going to be customizing the tutorial with a scenario related to those fishermen, but please feel free to customize this to your own data and pause the video throughout. There's a bunch of places where you're going to need to choose your own options, so take your time there and choose everything you need. The first step is to log on, so do you have credentials for an active eTrips account? If you don't or if you're not sure, call us during business hours at 978-282-0308. Press 2 for the stats main menu, and then press 1 to get through to speak to someone on the staff, and we will be happy to help you get online. For those of you who do have credentials handy, let's log in by entering your username and password in the related fields here, and then go ahead and tap the submit button. The account that I'm using here, this MA Test eTrips, is our departmental account. It's been wiped of data, so it should look like a brand new account. And if you have yet to use eTrips, it'll look just like mine here. There you go. There's your logbook and your trips. And as you see, there's nothing in there because we haven't entered anything yet. And we're going to. But before we get going, most of you are familiar with our paper report format, so let's take a look at the scenario we're going to be addressing on paper here. We have Mr. Fisher, our fisherman, permit number 9998, who departs from Ipswich on his unnamed vessel, registration number MS9999. On January 29th, 2024, he goes to the Plum Island Sound area known as Shellfish Classification Area N4. Starting at 8 a.m., harvesting until 1 p.m. with 4 hours of active fishing time. This haul garnered horseshoe crabs, 85 male, 43 female, all sold to dealer ACCSP for biomedical use. So, you know, mad lib this for yourself with your species, with your area, with your vessel. Just kind of plug in your own data as we go along. Let's look at the logbook again here. You'll see there's that entered trip report button beckoning you. Don't touch it yet, because our first step with this app is to configure our favorites. And you can't enter a trip till you've done that. So let's head there. Using the hamburger menu, those three lines in the upper left-hand corner next to the word logbook. That's what's known as a hamburger menu. It hints at a pop-up menu. So go ahead and touch it. And you'll see that menu pops up there at the corner of the screen. You are going to go down to favorites, the fourth option, which is where we set up our favorites. This section lets you customize your own lists so that you can quickly choose from the species, ports, and gears that you care about while you're entering here. The first favorite that comes up, as you see on the left-hand side there, you got species, areas fished, etc. First one is species. So we know that our species of choice is horseshoe crab. We can scroll through here by touching and dragging, or you can touch in the search field and type crab, and there you go. There's horseshoe crab. I'm going to touch that to star it, and that means I've saved it as a favorite. One thing you should know here, the keyboard comes up when you type in the search area. Maybe you don't want to do that. You might want to go back to scrolling just for operation's sake. If you touch at the top of the screen in the blank gray area above permit there, that will make that drop down. It's very similar to the operation of your iPad in other circumstances or your smartphone. But for us, we've got horseshoe crabs. Touch as many species as you get. I think this guy might also get razor and soft clam sometimes, so I'll add those here, but you can select and deselect anything just by tapping on it. So go ahead When you're satisfied, go ahead and move on to the areas fished here. And this is where you can choose the areas you commonly fish in. This is a really long list, so it's good that the keyboard comes up. We're going to search Plum Island Sound by typing Plum. And you'll see you got Plum Island and Plum Island Sound here. So any area you normally go, I guess this guy might also go to Cranes Beach. We'll put down N6 by searching the search bar, or if you want to search by your town, you can search Plymouth, South Coastal, North Coastal Harbor. Just use that to find what you're looking for. And if you don't know, again, in the associated text, you can check the shellfish classification areas map or the statistical reporting areas map to see what your areas fished are. But if you're doing paper reports, same thing, you write down there. Ports is where you can set up the ports you most commonly land trips. Again, that keyboard comes up, so let's just type in Ipswich, IPS. Brings up Mass, Essex, Ipswich. I'm going to touch that to favorite it. And you can scroll through there. Bristol, Dukes, Essex, etc. Choose any port you normally go to. And next up is gears. We're going to search the gears list here for rakes. So touch gears and then touch your finger and search. And rakes will come up here when you type rakes. Maybe this guy also does it by hand with no diving gear. I'll choose that. Feel free to choose anything you use here, but we're going to stop with rakes and by hand. Disposition is where you set the intended use of your catch. In this case, whereas a lot of you would be selling your fish as food, general food there, or using it for yourself, eating it for yourself, or for bait for yourself, in this case, we're going to set it for biomedical use, and perhaps sometimes our horseshoe crab fisherman sells them for bait. So we're just going to favorite those two options under dispositions. Vessels is where you can set your vessel here. So you have to set your vessel up by choosing the new button. This will come up with state highlighted. Leave that there and touch the new button. Our vessel is unnamed, so I'm going to just call it unnamed. UNNAMED. State registration, MS9999. And you have one or the other, a state registration or a dock. So I will be leaving dock blank. Make sure display in favorites is checked there. That should come up automatically. And you're ready to save your vessel choosing the save button in the bottom right-hand corner. And you see unnamed, your vessel shows up there, favorited with a star on it. Dealers is where you can select the dealers you most commonly sell to. This dealer we're going to sell to is a Test ACCSP. And we've got this ACCSP Tall Fisherman Production Test. That's going to be our dealer. Licenses, if you have multiple licenses, you could favorite one. We just have one. So that's it for us. At this point, we've set up our favorites and we are ready to enter a trip. So let's click on the back arrow between the hamburger menu and select favorites in the upper left-hand corner to get back to your logbook. So now we are ready to hit that enter a trip report button, and let's go ahead and enter that January 29th Ipswich horseshoe crabbing trip here. I'll let you know also, the first time you set these up, a lot of them will auto-populate after that. So trip type, commercial, since you're a commercial fisherman. If you have multiple vessels, pick from them. We have just our one there. And permit, we only have one, so that's going to come up all set. Let's go right ahead and click on the next button in the bottom right-hand corner. This takes us to our trip details. You can fill out any or all of these fields, but the only one you really need to fill out is end port. You can name your trip. You can give a partner VTR or add notes for yourself if you'd like to, but In this case, we're just going to add the port of Ipswich. If you're a charter fisherman who wants to keep notes, you could call it the Jones family trip and add notes on that day out. But otherwise, just give your port and go ahead and hit next in the bottom right. Effort details is where we're going to say where we fished. So the three mandatory fields here with the circles with exclamation points in them are primary area fished, waters fished, and gear type. I'm going to touch the down arrow next to primary areas fished, and in almost all cases for people reporting to us here at the DMF, you'll be choosing state waters inland. The waters fished, as we said in this report, is area N4, Plum Island Sound, and gear type is rakes. Gear quantity, we're a lean, mean operation, one man, one rake. I'm going to touch one. And it's an effort with catches. That comes up with the radio button filled in for you. Let's hope you need that more often than no catches, because that would be sad to go out and not catch anything. So we will set that button up for catches for you, which will trigger a catch page later on here. But first of all, let's click the next button in the bottom right-hand corner. And we're going to put our trip time and date in here. You're going to see the calendar and the clock here. First up, the calendar, when you go ahead and touch on trip start date, comes up on the current day, and to the you see there's the next and or previous and next arrows on the right and left-hand side of the month and year there. We're going to go back using the left arrow to January and touch January 29th for Monday, January 29th, 2024. That's our fishing date. Choose OK. Trip start time brings up the clock. This always comes up at 12, and since our start time was 8 a.m., we'll touch the 8, and that takes us over to minutes here. If it was 8:15, I could touch 15 there. If I could drag it right around the clock, I could, but we're going to set them right to 8 a.m. That's set. We'll click OK. Trip end date. Once again, we're going back a month to January and choosing the 29th. Then I'll choose OK. And the trip end time was 1 p.m. here. So I'm going to touch the 1 and 00, 1 p.m. If you had an earlier time, you could touch the a.m. p.m., set whatever you want. Otherwise, choose OK. Your effort length in hours here today is also required. And although 8 to 1 would be 5 hours, there was 4 hours of active rake in the sand time. So I'm going to register that as 4 hours and give it an OK. And I will go ahead and touch the next button in the bottom right. Bring us to where we specify what we caught. And for us, it's horseshoe crabs. And for this trip, it was 85 male horseshoe crabs, 43 female, both sold or offloaded, if you will, to ACCSP. So let's touch quantity, and I'm going to type 85 and hit OK. It's not pounds, it's count. So under unit of measurement, touch that down arrow and choose count. Catch disposition comes up automatically as biomedical in this case, but if you were selling them as bait, go ahead and select that. That's not the case for us, as we saw on the paper sheet. It's biomedical use. And under market and grade, a catch sources standard, that's something you can ignore. That's more for lobster and shellfish. Market and grade is where we can specify the sex of the horseshoe crab, and this was male in count, so that's great. I'm going to offload it right now by choosing the new button, which means I'm going to say what I did with them. And they went to ACCSP here. I had a couple of other favorites set up. I'm going to choose create. And I'm going to save here. This takes us back to catches because oftentimes in one day you'll catch more than one species. So for this one, we caught another species. It's another sex of the same species. 43 count, and go down to market and grade and specify female. So As you see, the second catch was 43 female horseshoe crabs, general use biomedical. I'm going to add them to an existing offload because these were both sold as one haul to ACCSP. So I've added that to that day's new offload that I created for the male horseshoe crabs. And at this point, I can choose save in the bottom right-hand corner. Takes us back to catches if you have more catches. If that's it, which it is for us, this satisfies our trip on January 29th to Area N4, departing Ipswich, hauling some horseshoe crabs back. Let's touch the offloads button. And there's a little summary of what you've offloaded, but you need to then upload this trip report. So if you see the bottom menu, you can go back to catches or to your offload. We're satisfied though. We're going to touch trip report. This is where you can submit your report here. You see it is checked off in the upper left-hand corner here for a trip from January 29th at 8 a.m. You just need, you can't touch that submit button until you have certified that the vessel trip information is true, et cetera, et cetera. So you need to touch that box there and check it off. And then the submit button will be activated. Go ahead and touch submit. And you will see the process of uploading here, which is uploading the information you have on your iPad or device to the SAFIS database. A successful upload should show us a cloud. Oh, well, the success right there. It's backing up your database. I'll show you the cloud in a second here. Let's touch done. There you go. Under your logbook, here's your first trip. You see it's a trip starting January 29th at 8 a.m. You see the permit there. But right above Monday 129, you see that cloud with an arrow. That means that trip has been successfully updated. So that is a successful trip here. Please don't hesitate to call us. We're always happy to help you. The phone number is 978-282-0308. Press option 2 for the stats main menu and then press 1 to speak to someone in staff. Please let us know if you have any feedback and reach out if you need anything. Thanks, folks.